The Prophet said, "Wa atbi'i sayyi'ata al-hasana." And when you commit any crime, ideally don't commit it. But again, you and I are all humans and we commit. In kana la yarjuka illa muhsin. The poet says, Allah, if only the pious can hope for you, then where do we go? Allah, if only the pious can turn to you, where do we go? Undoubtedly, his doors are open. If you do perchance commit a sin, and that's the essence of my topic, listen to me, my brother and my sister. Give me your undivided attention. May Allah reward Shaykh Hussein from inviting me all the way from South Africa. I'm here for 2 days only in your country. I hope my short stay can leave me motivated and you motivated, and it can become the means of our salvation on the day of Qiyamah. Whenever you do commit any wrong, then at least follow it up with a good deed that will erase the ill effect of your sin. Now, in theory, we all know what is wrong. I don't have to tell you, you don't have to tell me. You know the things that are forbidden. In Allah farada fara'idha fala tudayyi'uha wa hadda hududan fala ta'taduha wa sakata an ashya'a rahmatan lakum ghayra nisyanin fala tabhathu anha. Allah has ordained limits and Allah has made certain things obligatory and certain things forbidden. But for whatever reason, we succumb to that wrong and we commit it. So you know Saturday night, you shouldn't be messing around with that girl, but for whatever reason, you did it. You shouldn't be gambling, but you gamble. You shouldn't be involved in interest, but you have. My message is to you not to provoke you or advocate to you to commit the sin. But my message to you is that if you have committed the wrong, my brother, there is still hope. There is still hope. There was a sister here from North America, from Canada. I hope she is here, and if she's not here, may Allah take my message to her. She had sent me an email, and I praise her and I compliment her. And it brought tears to my eyes. She said, Shaykh, I had led a life unmindful of Allah and oblivious of Allah. And I have tattoos on my body. And now I have regretted and I want direction in my life. My question is, will my Allah accept my prayers like this or not? My sister, yes, Allah will accept your prayers. Ya sahib al-dhanbi la taqnatinna fa inna al-ilaha ra'ufun ra'uf. O sinner, don't despair, you are dealing with a kind Allah. O sinner, I don't want any man or any sister to walk out despondent. I want every brother to walk out of here with hope that there is a future for him. What does Allah say? وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Those who, when they commit a wrong, they reflect. It hurts them, it haunts them, it bothers them. And they turn to Allah and seek for forgiveness. And who is there besides Allah that can forgive? Two things I'll mention about this ayah. When this verse was revealed, the devil cried. That he said, as long as the believers have this concession, I have no hope. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ خَيْرٌ لِأَهْلِ الذُّنُوبِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. There is nothing that can give more solace to the sinner than this verse. There's nothing that can give more comfort to the perpetrator than this verse. Whatever your crime is, be you an adulterer or an adulteress, be you a thief or a thug, be you whatever, as long as you repent sincerely to Allah, this verse say Allah's doors are open for you. And really speaking, you know, at times, creation makes us appreciate how merciful Allah is. If a man is cheating against his wife, and I'm not saying cheat, please. You know, this 55-year-old man asked his wife, do you feel offended when I run behind young girls? This 55-year-old man asked his wife, do you feel offended? She says, no, why should I? Even dogs run behind cars. Why should I feel offended? Even dogs run behind cars. That is why they say this. Father asked his son, oh my son, what type of wife you want? He said, chan ki tarah, like a moon. So he says, oh my son, what do you mean by the moon? He said, jo raat ko aaye aur din ko chali jaye. one who appears by night and disappears by morning. But I'm not referring to our sisters here, no. Make no mistake. What am I saying? After you've committed a wrong, follow it up by a good action. Tamhuha, it will erase the effect of your sin. Now I want to show to you briefly, in the life of Sahaba, they are also human and hence they are prone to sin. And we all are prone to sin. In fact, in one hadith I read, and I take so much solace from this hadith, that the Prophet ﷺ said that لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُ, if you were not to sin, I feared a greater sin, and that is arrogance over the fact that you're sinless. If you were not to sin, I feared you would have become obsessed with your pure nature. But now when we talk about piety, every man drops his gaze because each man's evil haunts him and he flashes before him. You are saying what you know about me because you only know half. My wife, who doesn't know me in its entirety, she cannot respect me. She cannot respect me. So you can imagine, you know, I've said this in California, and many sisters have heard it and they always tell it to my wife, but I share it with you again. My wife always tells me that before I got married, when I proposed to her, she used to listen to my lectures very passionately. This is what she says. Allah knows best. Anyway, she says daily by night she used to listen, sleep with it, get up. But I'm married 11 years, she hasn't heard one. Since I'm married, I don't blame her. In fact, she tells me, and I respect her for this, you sound more pious than you are. You sound more pious than you are. Because that's, we know our reality. What did Allah say? وَأَعْلَمُ بِكُمْ إِذْ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَإِذْ أَنْتُمْ أَجِنَّةٌ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. You know, you tell a man, don't flatter yourself, don't trumpet yourself, I know you when you were a child. Allah says, don't praise you, don't praise yourself. I know you from the very time I intended your creation. Not from the time you were born or you were a fetus. إِذْ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. So it's difficult to impress a man who's got his past, who's got your past before you. Now what I'm saying is, we've all committed wrong. And I want to show to you from the hadith. The riwayat comes in Bukhari. Imam Bukhari mentions it in his first volume, Babun As-Salatu Kaffara. That good actions is an atonement for your wrong. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, Anna rajulan atan nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One person came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, oh Prophet of Allah, help me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what? He says, I've kissed a woman. And now I feel bad about what I've done. And that's the young boy I'm targeting. I want to speak to that boy and that girl who's done the wrong. And I guess I'm speaking to all, because which one of us doesn't have sins? In taghfir taghfir illahumma jamma wa ayyu abdin laka la alimma. Allah, if you forgive, forgive us all. Which one of your servant hasn't sinned against you? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, أقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات. Listen, you've done a wrong. Perform salah in the morning and the night, on the two ends of the days and in the night. Verily, the continuous performance of good deeds will erase the ill effect of your sins. So you've done a wrong, go do some good. Go do some good. Now I'll explain in more detail. The same hadith, I'll quote to you four hadith from Ibn Kathir rahimahumullah. The next hadith, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, one person came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulallah, every one of us will be able to relate to one or the other of the scenarios that will be explained. Inni wajadtu imra'atan fi bustani. O Nabi of Allah, I'm not proud to tell you, but I want to tell you, I found a beautiful woman in a garden and in an orchard. What they say in Arabic, nadhrun fabtisamun fakalamun famaw'idu. Nadhrun fabtisamun fakalamun famaw'idu. First it's the gaze, then it's the smile, then it's exchanging phone numbers, and thereafter the sin is committed. Nadhartu ilayha nadhratan fatahayyarat daqa'iku fikri fi badi'i sifatiha. فأوحى إليها الطرف أني أحبها فأثر ذاك الوحي في وجناتها. That is only for someone getting married, I can share those couplets. O Prophet of Allah, I seen this woman, I fell upon her. فَعَلْتُ بِهَا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. But he came emphatically and he said before the Prophet ﷺ, I did with her possibly everything that any young man would do with a beautiful woman. غَيْرَ أَنِّي لَمْ أُجَامِعْهَا. But alhamdulillah, I have not actually perpetrated the act of zina. قَبَّلْتُهَا وَلَزِمْتُهَا. I hugged her, I kissed her, I did many other things, but I did not perpetrate the actual action. Is there any hope for me? Is there any hope for me? Umar radiallahu anhu says, I looked at this man and I said, لَقَدْ سَتَرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ لَوْ سَتَرَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِ. Listen, we don't want to know what you did. Allah, conceal your fault, go from your man. What are you telling us? The Prophet ﷺ lowered his gaze. Jibreel descended. The Prophet ﷺ said, call that young man back. The Prophet ﷺ said, listen, Allah has revealed something for you. There's some concession. أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Allah says, perform salah and do good deeds. Allah will cancel all your sins. Allah will cancel all your sins. Now when the concession came out, when he initially came and he proclaimed his sin, then everybody said, what is this man talking? But when they heard the concession, then somebody stood up and he said, أَلَهُ خَصَّ أَمْ لِلنَّاسِ عَمَّ. Now tell us, O Prophet of Allah, is that concession applicable to us also, or is it exclusive to him? Because each man seen his own sins before him. The Prophet ﷺ said, no, بَلْ لِلنَّاسِ عَمَّ. This concession is open to my entire ummah till the day of Qiyamah. Hence it includes the North American youth, and it includes everyone in the entire world. You've done a wrong, the world is not over. But be honest in your regret. Be sincere in your lamenting. Allah loves those tears. Ruhul Ma'ani, one riwayat under Suratul Qadr, لَأَنِينُ الْمُذْنِبِينَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ زَجْلِ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. Allah says, the regrets of the sinners leaves me more impressed than the piety of the pious.